confidentiality of the DIN message, thanks to signature, is also quite high. But those are the possibilities on the OAuth side. So we can even use some assertions inside inside the OAuth. Then we have JWT assertion profiles, which is for requesting access tokens and client authentication. That's I think it's not a standardized yet. It's still in a draft stage. Both of them are actually in draft stage, I guess. Yeah, it is. key management. That's thing we, the one who is deploying the stuff should pay attention very much, and it's very important in SAML case because, as we said, the signatures are used very heavily inside the messages. So the whole setup has to be really good, and not in terms of PKY, but very similar stuff to this one is that the client ID and the secret tokens and the client credentials has to be stored on a secure storage. Eavesdropping, that's a thing which everybody knows that can happen, and could even happen if you have TLS on the both sides. And usually, SAML is like, thanks to the in-message confidentiality and in-transit confidentiality is also recommended, so it's a bit better, doing a bit better against eavesdropping. But OAuth is quite sensitive, and the in-transit has to be really mandatory, and everybody has to be sure. Then replay attacks. SAML is prone, cannot say that it's not, but also countermeasures possible because by the design of protocol there are some things we can be done. The same stuff for OAuth, basically. So you see that actually those differences are not something like which will enable to say us, hey, SAML is really old beast and it could be dumped out and we are going only OAuth way or the other way around. It's always has to be considered for the concrete solution we are talking about. And yeah, think first about the solution. So I would like to say that in Picketlink, it's a project I'm working on, we have the parts of the puzzle for both of them. However, supported is for now only SAML. SAML is, we have identity provider, we have part for the service providers. Then there is a Picketlink social, which is slowly going to the better state, and it is working, but I'm not sure if all the use cases which are defined in the standard are supported or actually are working fine. That's basically end of my talk, and just would like to point you to some bibliographies, and slides will be published somewhere, so everybody can probably check some of those very interesting stuffs. I should say that recently I read this book, which I like a lot and really can recommend it. Yeah, and sure, make sure you take a look to Picketlink website, and maybe you can you can get it for a little ride, and let us know on the forums or by email, whatever works for you better. Any questions? not 3, 2.1. Summer 2.1 is on, I think, on currently in some draft, what I've seen, but not sure about OAuth, but I think OAuth as well. There are some fixes, and it's still going on, because after some time of usage, you always find that, okay, those things described here are not really like they meant to be, and, or somebody clever found some way around, so that's why. And the same stuff like with OAuth 1.0 and 2.0, it's almost completely different point, different stuff. Jasné.
Tušíte někdo, proč ten náš redhatácký samoserver běží na JBossu?
A čemu je zle? Albo čo je zle s JBossom?
No, JBoss je super, ale když to chceš jako jenom samoserver, tak myslíš, že má smysl, aby to běželo fakt vyloženě jako na aplikáci.
Taky perlový skript by stačil, ne? Na Raspberry Pi, tak někde.
Mně přijde, že se to strašně dlouho načítá, jako vždycky. Já teda nevím, jestli je to úplně, jestli
no,
to
není.
Na aplikáci, nebo jestli je to... Jestli je tam pomalý nejaký backend pod tým?
No, není to problém. Ja si nemyslím, že to je úplne tak pomalé, akože tým, alebo teda, že to pomalé je zrovna spôsobené tým, že tým JBossom. Ne, to IT, to je setup IT. My ako to beží na Picket Linku, áno, to je, keď ten Picket Link je v niečom pomalý, tak áno, je to naša vina, ale myslím si, že to závisí od toho, ako je to nasadené. Či tam je nejaký klaster nasadený, alebo nie, podľa toho, koľko je tam týchto. Ale ja si nemyslím, že ten IDP by to bolo až tak jednoduché, super, že by si tam mohol dať nejaký perlový skript, ktorý by volal nejakú túto. No, ale čo je to samoserver? Je to identity provider, alebo je to service provider, ktorý aj obidvaja musia rozumieť samo, áno? A ten identity provider musí v podstate si šahnúť potom do toho LDAPu, hej, napríklad, alebo ja už pakujem, preč.
Jo, to je práve to, čo som...
Tam je toho, ja neviem, ja to neskúmam, to,